When gunmen opened fire outside of an event showing Prophet Mohammed depictions, one of their targets might have been this man, Dutch far-right politician Geert Wilders, who thanked police for protecting him with this picture on his Twitter account. Earlier, he ripped into critics of the event.
They want to prohibit cartoons, books, and films which they found insulting. And our answer is, don't mess with Texas. Don't mess with the free West and don't mess with our freedom of speech.
But what Wilders calls free speech, critics call hate speech. In 2011, he was charged but acquitted of inciting hatred for comparing the Quran to Hitler's Mein Kampf. He also tried to get Islam's holy book banned in Holland. For years, Wilders has been campaigning to curb immigration to the Netherlands from Muslim countries, combating what he calls the Islamization of Europe. In 2008, he produced a short film called Fitna, which argued that Islam encourages acts of terrorism, anti-Semitism, and violence towards women, outraging Muslims and rights groups. He made his views clear in an interview with CNN in 2010.
It would be ridiculous to say that all Muslims are terrorists. Unfortunately, almost all terrorists are Muslims, but not the other way around. Still, I believe that we should have a stop of the mass immigration from Islamic countries, not because the people are bad, but because they bring along a culture that really is against everything of our own values and against our freedom.
His message resonates with many voters in his native country. Wilders' Freedom Party is currently represented in the Netherlands as well as the European Parliament. But there's also a lot of public backlash, like when Wilders came to England in 2010 to speak in front of the House of Lords.
I don't think that you can have a logical argument with a fascist because they're a fascist.
Wilders has been under police protection since 2004, protection that seems to have been necessary for him and the other participants of the event in Garland, Texas.
Very controversial man, someone who, as we've seen, has been in the crosshairs several times. Apparently, there have been several plots that have been thwarted to kill him in the past. He apparently has also been on Al-Qaeda's hit list since 2010, when he was named in Inspire magazine, which is, of course, attributed to Al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula, as someone who has insulted Islam and is therefore wanted by them dead or alive. So certainly someone who would have had that extra protection there in Garland, Texas, Becky.